That's exactly what we wanted to do.
Let's do it.
That's,
okay.
I couldn't have done that. I was like, girl, you're too far.
Yes, cool. Let's go.
I've heard some rumors that you are in a committed bromance with Josh Hutcherson. Can you confirm or deny said bromance?
100% confirm.
Completely.
Are you making the other castmates jealous?
I think Jen maybe. I hope. That was the intention.
Right.
The only reason I'm getting close to Josh is to make Jen jealous.
I'm actually looking forward to seeing him soon.
Oh really?
No, I'm excited.
Are you guys coordinating your press conference, like outfits?
Outfits, yeah. We're going to be wearing the same matching outfits, a bit like twins, Arnold Schwarzenegger and Danny DeVito.
I mean, it would be really disappointing if you didn't.
I think there's a kind of bro-homance between all three of us.
I like that.
The bro-homance.
So there was a little mouth-to-mouth resuscitation in the film. How soft were the lips?
So soft.
Were they?
Like, honestly, Jen's such a lucky girl. but no, I got my 4 minutes of enjoyment.
Of heaven? Like they called it seven minutes
of heaven, yeah.
4 minutes with Josh.
I definitely had butterflies.
You did too?
Yeah.
Okay, good, I'm not alone.
Can we switch seats?
Yeah.
I actually did practice on a dummy for
you
about
did?
3 hours.
That's
one day.
Not nice to call
three
Josh
hours?
A dummy.
No, I'm talking about Liam now. No, I'm kidding.
Did they set that up?
Yeah.
Like
yeah,
they
yeah.
brought in an actual dummy? Did you go to the dummy or did they bring the dummy
the
to your hotel
The dummy
came
room? To me. No, it was on set. It was on set.
Oh,
yeah.
Okay.
I full on made out with the dummy for about 3 hours.
Nice.
And then I made out with Josh. It's like my favorite film ever. It was intense and warm and
I was dead.
Sticky.
Moist.
Did you enjoy the fact that I was dead?
Yeah, I've got a tendency to kiss dead people.
Really?
No. In films. I'm talking about Snow.
Look at this.
On you. I'm talking about Snow White and yourself. So
I don't
think
like wiping it. Melissa came up with that. I don't agree.
You're saying me and Snow White have a lot in common?
Ouch.
Have to be awakened by your kisses?
After seeing this handy little watch candy, I'd love to see my face, you know, people could eat my face every day.
Say thank you, everyone. Every single one of you that's camped out overnight. Do you want a sugar cube? Booyah!
Big pockets if you're in. Keep them.
Come see me later and I'll give you one. All right, cool. Well, I mean sugar cube.
Yeah. We go.
Josh or Sam?
Jeffrey.
Back the F off. Do you know, I'm pretty dangerous as a person in this. Not like physically. Mm-hmm. But
danger prone.
Yeah, I'm so accident prone. I have a feeling that if someone tried to do anything to me, I'd probably end up hurting myself and them at the same time. So I think I'm probably my best weapon. I think me and Jen are in constant competition to see who could fall over the most. I also think the Hawaiian jungle had a real problem with me. One of the bushes stabbed me in the eye, nearly blinded me, which you saw, right?
Yeah.
Well, I think if I knew, ran into it.
No, it ran into me.
I walked into a bush and nearly blinded myself. I broke a finger.
Broke someone else's hand too, didn't you?
No, I knocked him out, though.
I knew there was something.
There was a day that me, Jen and Josh all climbed to the top of the cornucopia and had a bag of candy. Like loads of sweets, and we were just sort of hiding and throwing them at crew members who obviously thought, like, what? Come on, what's
the game's started.
Something's going on. That's really weird bird doo-doo.
So if you could create a GIF to go viral on the internet with one moment from Catching Fire on screen or off screen, what would you choose?
I think for
Five
my character,
seconds.
It would be the passing of the sugar cube. It would just be wouldn't it? Like, with sugar cube. sugar cube. Yeah.
Do you think Finnick's most powerful weapon is his trident or his charm?
I mean, me with a trident?
No,
I was pretty.
Finnick.
Me being Finnick? Okay, Finnick's most powerful weapon. I'd say his trident, right? I mean, I can't kill people with my charm. Oh, wait,
can you kill people
with his charm. Maybe I can. I am English. No, I don't know. I'd say.
I'm English.
I'm English. So,
okay.
As an Englishman, I'd say trident. Yeah.
But no, I mean, Finnick is definitely, you know, a confident, charming, sexually manipulative. I love that word.
How do you find invisible monkeys?
How do I fight one?
Yeah.
You just swing.
swing and swing and swing some more. Like, I don't know, I was hitting bushes and Jennifer, you know, anything that looks half like a monkey, hit it.
Like, I remember we were swinging tridents, we were in mid-take, mid-flow, we were fully going for it, and then all of a sudden Jen just let out this God Almighty scream, like, I mean, full-on let loose. And everyone was like, whoa, 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 what's happened? She was like, something's just bit me, something bit me. So everyone was like, you know, there's nothing in here, like, you know, so we were all sort of traipsing around trying to find some sort of snake or anything. Eventually, as I was getting out of the water, someone said, oh, Sam, the end of your trident's come off. And I was like, what? Like, and, you know, obviously the fork end, but then the other end, there's this little metal bit, like spiky bit. So I was like, oh, my God. And then I was like, did you see where it went? They were like, yeah, right by where Jen was. And I was like, oh, I started putting two and two together. I was like, oh, God. I eventually went to the video village where Jen was, and she'd pulled her wetsuit down to see what it was. And there was this perfect imprint of, like, the end of my trident. Like, just slap bang right on the end of her ass, and she was like, what is that? What? Something's bit me. What are these teeth? And I was like, no. Like, that was me.
Where was this?
It was a very special moment we shared. All the crew and the cast shared that moment, and I can only say that I'm sorry.
I took a spill. It was the first day I had to pick Lynn up, and whoever decided to give me the responsibility of another human life, yeah, made a mistake. But basically, I picked her up first time, and we sort of walked off the spoke onto the beach, and the rocky spoke, you know, in the arena, and it was all fine. We decided we were going to go for a take, so I was like, yeah, fantastic. You know, obviously, we're going to be running off this time, so I got her on my back, we started running, and I took a spill, and my knee slammed into the rock, and I was like, Lynn, let go, because, I have to explain that she was not allowed to go into the water because her blood pressure went so ridiculously high. So after I took my knee into the rock, she was clinging on for dear life, and I was like, Lynn, please get off. I'm going in. Yeah, we went in.
You tried to kill every cast member of Catching Fire.
Too many responsibilities.
What I'm trying to say is never cast me ever again. Yeah.
Your friend and colleague, the other bestie.
Handsome, good looks.
Yeah. Generous heart.
Great kisser.
You guys are making me sick. This is so sweet.
Sorry, what?
All right.
I did 6 months of practicing with my grandmother before. I actually walked into the audition room with my grandma on my back, which I think Francis Lawrence really appreciated. I then offered him a sugar cube, and then I stripped down to nothing but a knot, covering my crotch.
With a sugar cube?
With a sugar cube. And, wait. There was at least a packet of sugar cubes.
No, you didn't. You went there.
Do you feel you can relate to your character in any which way?
I relate to
he says yes, definitely.
Jenna, for you, there's the elevator scene where, of course, there's the illusion that you're naked. On set, how naked do you have to be for a scene like that?
Was there any strutting?
I think she thinks. I was a Boy Scout, so I wore my ties, Cub Scout honor. I kind of.
Same as Hunger Games thing, isn't it?
It is, funnily enough. Okay. X Files. But no, you know, I got all my badges, and I'd like to think of myself as an outsider.
Everyone's always thought of you as an outsider.
Yeah, they forced me to become an outsider.
I like to be outdoors, is what I'm trying to say.
I also like pornography.
I know.
Ah, that seems like the perfect mix.
And thank you very much.